I mean, the first decision was to change the crowns that we make. Okay. We dealt with Benco, and I just really didn't want to deal with another company. So the next step was, okay, now let's convert the lab. So what do we need to do that's going to be compatible? And, you know, they had recommended Armand Gerbach, and so we took a visit down there.
When we went down to Armand Gerbach, what we covered there mostly was what our needs were. And they asked us what our needs were, what were we planning to do, what kind of things we're planning to make.
I just felt they were extremely professional, very knowledgeable, very precise. So then we decided, well, if we're going to do this, we're going to jump in with both lungs, and that's what we did.
And so we then take all of our old technology out, all of our old burners and the casting wells and the burnout ovens, and we put this stuff in.
Went the whole nine yards. You know, including two different burnout ovens, two different mills, of course the design center. And then they came and they did some training, extensive training with our lab techs. And then they came back and did some more training.
I got to sit down as a technician and actually design one with one of the technicians there, Richard.
Training was very good, very explanatory, very detailed, very easy to communicate with.
I was taught many years ago how to make crowns. Basically by hand, and now it's all digital. You design it on a computer, it goes to a machine, the machine mills it out, and basically all you have to do is glaze it.
For me now, when I put a crown in, it may take me 5 minutes, or before it might be 20 to 30 minutes. But I think the patient really senses, oh, they're really kind of doing things the right way, and we're not putting pressure material in their mouth, we're scanning it. And then they see it, and then they actually become kind of involved in their own treatment. Then when you go to put the crown in, and like I said, it's literally like, okay, put it in, try it in, check the bite, look at it, let's glue it. It's that quick. And it's like, well, that's because we have dialed it down to the hundredth of a millimeter.
Well, we had a gentleman in this morning from Boston. He had an old restoration of porcelain-fused metal. And one of the problems with porcelain-fused metal is they can delaminate, mm-hmm. or the porcelain comes off of the metal substructure. Mm-hmm. And this is what had happened. So what we did for him today was we prepped him. Mm-hmm. The doctors prepped him. Scanned it, sent it to us, and we wet milled him a crown. It took from the prepping to the wet milling of the crown probably about an hour, hour and a half. And he's coming back at 2 o'clock this afternoon, and he will have a permanent restoration put in.
It's changed the way we practice. It's changed the way we think. It's just, you know, you're going from listening to a cassette tape to, you know, playing streaming live. Benco's been phenomenal.
The Benco installers, those guys are awesome.
They have their support. And we've had to call on that a few times, and they've been there. I mean, they've been solid. I mean, Rich is great. Dan Rude's been great. Anybody I've met there has been really, really good.
The techs are great.
You feel you have the support. It's not, oh, hey, okay, we made this sale. I'm moving on to the next sale.
Those guys came out, and they know it. They're clicking. They know it. So we call them if we have a problem, you know, and they really help out.
It's a no-brainer.